All right, guys, what's up? Got another Let's Watch. Sorry for the delay, and sorry for not doing any of the other games. Kind of messed that up. Kind of fell behind. Got some things going on personally right now. My car's not doing too well, so I'm working on getting a new car right now. So I've been more car shopping than working on videos. But for my prediction for the end of the wild card, it was pretty close to right. Except I thought the Giants would beat Green Bay. Because once the Giants make the playoffs, they're like the best team of all time for some reason. But that's the only one I was wrong on. So both my simulations were right. Pittsburgh won and Seattle won. Seattle, in my opinion, screwed Detroit. It kind of seemed like the refs were favoriting Seattle, but it doesn't really matter. I'm not a Lions fan. I feel bad for you guys. But for this one, Seattle at Atlanta, I think, I don't want that echoing. I think Atlanta will take this one with home field advantage. And after the simulation, I'll come back and I'll talk to you guys in a bit. Enjoy.
And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. He'll get it running right. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Michael Bennett's versatility, being able to play any position along the defensive front, allows him to make those types of plays. He finds good matchups and gets into the offensive backfield.
And there it works for a tackle for loss. On second down, Freeman. Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. Past the 20, and all the way down to the 9. A big run there by Freeman. 69 yards. And Freeman, not sure if he was a surprise exactly, but he sure took the NFL by storm.
But when you talk with his team, they'll tell you they saw this coming. They knew he had the talent. They were just ready to turn him loose on a full-time basis, and he took full advantage of it.
And now one of the most electrifying runners in the game today. First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
On that play, it was the defensive front that won the battle. They out-leveraged the offensive line, got into the backfield, and held them to no gain.
Watch 18. Watch 18. Single,
slot. Ready. Running out of over there. Now they'll throw it with Ryan. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones from 8 yards out. And the Falcons take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Now Matt Bryant on for the point after. It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. On the return, the old reliable Devin Hester, the veteran. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. Play fake here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And it drops down incomplete.
Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Off the play fake to Rawls. Wilson. And his throw is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. On third down, Wilson. And the third down pass falls incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jermaine Kearse, and it's fourth down.
So the defense forces a three and out, but they got some help along the way. They threw it on first down, and when they were unsuccessful, it became second and long. Didn't get it again on another pass. Went third and long, and they almost had to put it in the air. They may want to rethink some strategy going forward.
This will be fielded at the 17. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And it'll be Falcon football as they take possession. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It's out with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. He takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about four.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
So second and medium, second and five now. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38. And credit the tackle to Cliff Avril.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Ryan now to throw on third down. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. And fourth down coming up.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
On fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on to punt. And that is how you do it, my friends. This will be spotted out of bounds inside the 5-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Here's Thomas Rawls with his first carry. And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down.
All right, when you think of the Seattle Seahawks partner, especially on offense, what's the first thing that comes to mind?
Russell Wilson.
Yeah, what's the second thing that comes to mind?
Russell Wilson.
Okay, I'm going to get you off of Russell Wilson. How about how they run the football?
Yeah.
And they got it back against the Lions in the playoffs when Thomas Rawls went for 161 yards, which is a franchise record in a playoff game. If they have that going, they're going to be very dangerous throughout the playoff run.
Well, and what's interesting, last three... And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can end it.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense. chance and have it end up in the end zone.
18 yards on the pickup there. And that one, Atlanta first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. On second down, here's Ryan. This will be caught at about the six. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch. A nickel look by Seattle on third down.
Yep, five defensive backs now. From the gun on third down, Ryan. That's caught at the three. It'll be a two-yard gain, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Now, that's going to be a tough one to explain when they get together to watch the game film, isn't it? I mean, they had the right call, had the out route. He's got to know where the first down sticks are, yet he steps out of bounds that close. Not their best play.
And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. And the lead moves to 10-0. So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach, but it kept the offense out of the end zone.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. Now Hester will get a shot. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And out now come the Seahawks. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
The drive begins with a run by Rawls. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
They go again with Rawls. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29. Adrian Claiborne, the one who makes the stop.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. From the gun on third down, Wilson. He's got time. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
And they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position. But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many pro style, we actually have a true fullback. We're having to make do in the NFL and put guys in that spot who emulate it but aren't necessarily that position. Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Second down, they need less than a yard to pick up the first.
Four down, check. Four down.
On second down, Rawls. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
So the offense has it first and 10. Penalty, it's Rawls, and this time they were ready for him as he's taken down at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made there by Robert Alford.
No gain on that run, and while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
On second down, Wilson. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the shotgun, Wilson. He's got Curse. A good pickup there, 26 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
They go play action here on first down. That's caught at the one. Only 2 yards on the completion at second down.
See, in that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
On the ground, Rawls. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
Did your high school have that same push them back cheer?
I was a kicker.
Well, it certainly worked. Didn't matter if we were kickers or not. That one worked, didn't it? They pushed him back at his last snap of the ball, and boy, they created a nice play for themselves. Would they lose three on that one?
Yeah, from the one back to the four. On third and goal, Wilson. Surveying the field. That's caught at the one. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Jimmy Graham from 4 yards out. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. Steven Hauschka for the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This fielded at the two. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. They've got it second and 10 to start things out. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. On second down, Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Freeman again. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
Really good, skillful, tough running throughout this contest. Picked up first down after first down. He's got to have a nickname, doesn't he? How about the human first down machine? I think that fits.
They'll run here with Freeman. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Now they'll throw it with Ryan. Here as he's taken down. Jaron Reed able to get in and run him down for what will be a loss of 15 yards.
Well, in my time in football, I've yet to see a playbook that draws up offensive plays designed to lose yardage. A running play loses yardage on first down. They try and throw it, take a sack on second down. What can the offensive coordinator come up with here on third down?
Now it's Ryan. He's got time in the pocket, letting one go deep. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Mohamed Sanu, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Oh, such great concentration there, going right up against the side of the end zone, but able to get the feet in bounds.
There's so many things.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. It's good to make it 17-7. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field. Punch it in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end. and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
A fake to Rawls. Now it's Wilson. Finding time. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
On third down, Wilson. He'll dump it off to Procise. The 13 yards that time at a first.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
First down, this is Rawls. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Well, so much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
Now Wilson on first down. Out to the right here to Wilson. A gain of 6 there on first.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second. Nine yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down. On second down, Wilson. They set up the screen to Rawls. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Well, they get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down. Wilson turns and gives to Procise. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was. His defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
He had the distance, but it's no good. Wide to the right, and this score will stay right where it is.
It looked good when it left his foot, but he kind of sliced it a little bit, and he winds up missing it wide right.
The drive, trying to run inside, but nothing there. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense, holding them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only 1 on that play.
Everyone, you got 4 down. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. Now Ryan on 2nd down. Connects with Sanu right side. And he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
Well, for teams that like to play man coverage, Running corner routes can be tough on them because of the ability of getting into it. Sometimes you're squaring it off. Sometimes you're just rounding it. Sometimes there's a fake. Sometimes there's not. That makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. Freeman. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, a guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. On third down, Ryan. And he's got his man in stride, complete. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going
to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, come get a little bit closer
this
time.
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And the two-minute warning lurking. This will probably be the last play before we hit it.
Yeah, they want to get themselves in position to score in this last shot before the clock hits.
Wilson to give to Rawls. And they're able to get this one across the 35. And now a first down following that long gain. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And the grab made by Doug Baldwin. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On first down, Wilson. Complete outright to Kurz. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Jermaine Kurz, 46 yards. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again. And he showcased his blazing speed on that one.
Was he wearing football cleats or track spikes? Because he was gone. Big time play. And just think about what that does if you're a receiver on the team with him. Well, that's got to open things up for you as well, because if I'm a defense, I've got to get back deeper and deeper in order to keep him in front. But I'm not sure how many can actually keep him in front with that speed.
Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back, Let's get back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
Caught by Sanu. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Second down now after the pass completion. Again, Ryan. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And the return across midfield and to the 46-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. Wilson snags it left side. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Wilson. And he is going to lose yardage here. He went backwards 5 yards there on third down to break up fourth. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. So we... Hey, Charles, you give me water. Jeez, Chuck, they cut off the halftime show again. Quicker than anticipated, ready for the start of the second half. Second half starts with a run by Rawls. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back. And now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
And he's got some space here. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
Double tight, double tight.
Wilson going to give to Rawls. And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Grady Jarrett with the tackle. And a couple of big boys up front defensively. And in that 4-3, those D tackles so vital.
Extremely vital. I love how you described that, because if they control things up front, often it's over the guard. Sometimes they slide and make it over the center. It's really hard to get a play started then, because a lot of teams want to start inside out running the football. But against a good 4-3, you may not find any space. But on that play, there was zero space, no gain.
Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends, because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
On third down, Wilson. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
No gain on the play there, second down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big time play there.
They come out here in the eye. Here's Wilson. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Ryan leaves with Freeman on the draw. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line, making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense. Alone to the right is Jones. Now it's Ryan. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cliff Averill in there to get him for a loss of 9, and that'll lead to fourth down. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively, pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well, and that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
On the return, Hester. So a change of possession here on the punt. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time, the turnover on the fumble. And they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard. Had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance. And to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
All right, we've got a minute here, partner. How about the matchups in the NFC divisional round? Seattle at Atlanta, a rematch of a game they played earlier this year that many thought Atlanta outplayed Seattle and should have won the ball game. And then go on to Green Bay, Dallas. There's not much history in that matchup, is there?
Yeah, that's the eighth time that they will be meeting in the playoffs. Cowboys won it earlier this year in Green Bay, week six. Also, Falcons and Seahawks, that's a rematch of the 2013 divisional round.
I mean, I love those matchups. And remember, Dallas going to Green Bay earlier this year really heralded the fact that Dak Prescott had taken over the Cowboys team.
So third and medium here, third and five. From the gun on third down, Wilson escapes the sack. Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Adrian Claiborne in there to drop him for a six-yard loss, and that'll lead to a fourth down. Here's John Ryan now as he's on to punt for Seattle. Taking it about the 16. So possession goes over here on the punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. And here now come the Falcons. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Now Ryan gonna give it to Freeman. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's some pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there when you see these nice, explosive, strong runs. And this guy, he knows how to carry the football really well and continually wants the football. Why? He knows the offensive line's going to give him great effort, and he gives great effort himself to finish off runs.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down of the offense in search of 6 yards. Now they'll throw it with Ryan toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
On third down, Ryan. He's got time. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
And right now I take my rudimentary kindergarten skills and draw where the tackle box would be, because that was close. I thought he was in the tackle box. He has to be very careful where he gets rid of the football from that spot.
Yeah, they say there was a receiver in the area, though.
Yeah. There's always a receiver in the area.
And he'll try and keep this away from Hester as this is going toward the sideline. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else. Bills.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try to hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
His throw incomplete. He was looking for Thomas Rawls there. Well, you know what we need to do? We need to give a hat tip to two guys that are riding off into the sunset. Steve Smith and Robert Mathis both have announced the end of their careers.
Let's start with Robert Mathis. You see all the tributes coming from around the league. Everyone talks about what an exceptional pro Robert Mathis has been throughout his career. And the guy has over 120 sacks in his career as well. And how about Steve Smith? Came into the league as a punt returner and became a WR1. How about that? One of the all-timers, I think both of them are going to merit Hall of Fame consideration, and both of them should get plenty of votes. Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They go play action now. Wilson surveying the field. Great protection. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well. And every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Here's John Ryan now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Now Freeman, he's been busy today. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over. Right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover and wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Sanu with a grab over the middle. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route. And then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They come out here in the eye. A handoff, Devontae Freeman. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Now Ryan on 2nd down. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it but was not in bounds. Incomplete. Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is 3rd down. From the gun on 3rd down, Ryan. And this is going to be incomplete. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This will be kicked from the 42. It's a 52-yard attempt. And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. And they stretch the lead to 6. It's 20-14 now. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. On second down, here's Ryan. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. And he's able to get up here to the 26. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. They'll run it now out of the gun. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Now Ryan. And did he get the feet down? No. They'll say he did not. It's incomplete. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. On third down, Ryan. He's got time in the pocket. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. Here's Matt Bosher now as he's on to punt for Atlanta. Here's Hester. A good return there, 17 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Still back there. He's going to go up top again. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
Have to give a lot of credit to the defense on that play. They were prepared. Ordinarily, when they take the big shot downfield to the big guy, that's usually a mismatch that the offense is used to winning. But the preparation showed for the defense, and they were able to bat it away.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. On third down, Wilson. And he comes back with one complete. It'll be a gain of eight, but it also lead to a fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. They'll run for it. Rolls. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. It's a four-yard pickup. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
I guarantee every coach wants to go for it on fourth and one in this spot. But so few of them have the guts to do it in their own territory. But he puts his faith in his offensive line, and they're able to pick up the first.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it and lost it there. And it'll be second down.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And, boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
So second and 10 here. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's brought down. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Good throw. Receiver does his job, and it's a first down for the offense.
Excellent execution all the way around. Plenty of time for the quarterback and the receiver to work their first down magic.
They go play action here on first down, finding time. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football, because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. To throw again is Wilson. And he is going to be wrapped up and swung to the turf. The corner blitz gets there as he goes down for a loss of 7.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Third and long, it's Wilson. Complete, Richardson has it. 14 yards, but they're still well shy of a first as that leads to fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. Spins off the left upright and deflects away. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So plenty of leg, but it's the accuracy there that lets him down.
Yeah, he hit it really well. I think this might have been good from 55, but you'll see it just conk off that upright, and they're denied a chance at 3 points.
First down. The left side completion to Jones. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Charles on the slant. You always need good ball placement. They got it there.
Brandon, the quarterback, put it in the exact perfect spot, right to the upfield shoulder of the receiver, and he used his body to keep the defender away.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. A 20th carry now for Freeman. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. They got two of the three they needed there. It leaves them with third and just a yard. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
On third and one, Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Freeman at tailback. He's got it running left. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 14 there, and it'll be first down Atlanta.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice gain.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now a play fake here on first down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Here we go with 2nd and 7. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. And he'll get it up the middle. And he's going to fight his... And now the Seahawks are going to call another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here. And we'll be back. And they're just a couple of yards shy of a first down here on third down. They run. Devontae Freeman. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And he'll try and throw here on the fake. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team.
And this will be caught at the third. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27. In the slot on the right is Graham. Back to throw. End zone caught. Touch Seattle. Doug Baldwin, 26 yards. And the Seahawks are within the extra point of taking the lead.
Well, I don't want to overlook the touchdown because that was huge. That ties the game. But you know where I'm going, don't you?
Need the PAT, and then you need to stop on defense.
Yeah, in a big way. The guy kicking the ball through the posts, that's where all the spotlight shifts to now.
Now to send this one away following the score. Here's Eric Weems now on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. And now they're in the hurry up. He'll look to throw. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. They'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field. And
now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They'll try and burn some clock with Rawls. And a showcase. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. They'll come out in the pistol. Throwing now is Wilson. He's got time. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but...
And a fake here. Direct snap to the up man. And the gamble pays off. They get the first.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here.
That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside.
Alright, so that game was intense at the end. I couldn't believe Seattle pulled that comeback off. I haven't seen a comeback like in a simulation for me before. It's always been back and forth, or one team just flat out, like they're two scores ahead at this point. You know they're going to win. But Atlanta had three timeouts on their last drive, hurried up on offense, and threw an interception. That was ridiculous. Either way, that was fun to watch. I was entertained the whole time. The way it first started out, in my opinion, like what Freeman got that, was like a 60-yard run for a touchdown. But no, it wasn't a touchdown. It was like you got to the 8-yard line. 149 rushing yards. I was like, yep. I was like, that's going to be Atlanta's game. I was like, it has to be. And then Seattle pulled it off. But, all right, so that's that simulation. According to me, in my simulation, Seattle wins 21-20. Very close and enjoyable defensive game. And I hope for you Seahawks fans, I hope you are happy about that. And Atlanta fans, I'm sorry that your team didn't win that one. But I hope you all enjoyed. Good luck to your teams in divisional round. See you on the next one. Peace.